Incredible. Incredible. I'm just blown away.
I feel like I'm on an acid trip.
You kind of get lost in all the on the art that's in there, you know what I mean? It brings you in and you don't want to leave.
It is infinity, whichever direction you look at. It's a totally immersive experience. It's like being out floating in the stars.
We're so small, don't we?
Something that is so whimsical and fantastical that you don't think of anything else.
It was definitely one of the highlights of the calendar this past year in the arts community, the dazzling, illusionary work of Yayoi Kusama, the Japanese art sensation. Her installment that you see here, Infinity Mirror Rooms, was at the Art Gallery of Ontario in Toronto last spring. The gallery started a crowdfunding campaign to try to house it permanently, and you can understand when you see it. And they gave themselves 30 days to reach a goal of $1.3 million. The deadline fast approaching. John is here. I am kicking myself. I didn't go in June. I didn't realize how gorgeous it is.
Well, you had to line up for an awfully long time.
Every time
I went by the AGO, even early in the morning, there were crowds of people, many of them young people. And of course, that's the point of some of this, to introduce a whole new generation to works of art. Kusama is 88 years old, continues to work hard and sell her works all around the world. Her studio is based in Tokyo. But the show really was a success, almost 200,000 people over 3 months coming to the AGO to see this. Now, she's famous for her infinity rooms that then use mirrors and lights, her polka dot mushrooms seen around the world as well, part of this. And so the AGO wants to join 18 other museums around the world and say, we would like our own permanent infinity room. And so some of you, 200,000 people who came to see the show, would you be prepared to buy it? So the total cost, some $2 million. This is a situation where they would have to raise 1.3 so far. And we'll show you, if we can, the page that they're hoping to do the fundraising on. They're up to about 566,000 last we checked. So this being the last day, not quite there, but still, the museum is hoping to get this work in there.
It could be a white knight to rescue in the last hours.
Exactly. You know, this is a situation where people say a room full of polka dot mushrooms with a bunch of mirrors, $2 million, I don't know. We're going to show you Marcel Duchamp's, one of his ready-mades. This now just over 100 years old. We don't really need to explain what it is. There it is, the famous Duchamp. It recently sold for almost $2 million, part of his ready-mades collection. So I don't know, your choice. A porcelain appliance or a room full of mirrors and polka dot mushrooms. So the price is about the same. Heather?
What is it? In the eye of the beholder?
It certainly
absolutely
is. Yes.
So it's interesting. You see how people are interacting with that in that whole exhibit, exposition. Most times you have security guards telling you, get away with the camera, don't get too close. It's been a very different approach.
Yeah, and it depends on the gallery, and to a certain extent it depends on the work of art as well. The Louvre, for example, no selfies, no photographs. Part of the concern is especially older works of art with the pigment could effectively, the argument is, be hurt by constant flashing of lights. The other aspect is that in the era of selfie sticks and people crowding around and photo bombing and everything else, that could not only destroy the art experience for others, but could in fact endanger the work of art itself because of all the jostling that goes on. When we look at some of the works that are out there, and let's have a shot of something that is coming out in terms of that is on at museums. I've got a gallery that I was at in the MoMA. I'll just give you an example. There it is here. Okay, now this is from the Museum of Selfies. This is from Los Angeles.
Right.
So that is a way of encouraging people to come in and take photographs.
Okay.
So it's not the Prado, and it certainly isn't the Louvre. But here's a shot that took place in New York. There it is. This was the Museum of Modern Art. This was a recreation of a club in New York in the 1970s. This is by Kenny Scharf. And that's me there.
It's like the Scream.
It is. Well, there it is. So this is a room that you enter.
Ooh.
It's all lit up like this. And the encouragement is there to definitely take pictures. It's all about people. And there it is. A group of tourists from Spain asked me to take their picture, and I obliged. It may not be the Mona Lisa that people are taking selfies with, but getting people involved, like at the Kusama exhibit, or as the MoMA was doing with that exhibit, they're getting some free publicity, and they're encouraging people to take selfies.
John, thanks. We'll find out
okay.
if they hit their target.
Cheers.
John Northcott.